Find extremal of functional I of y of x z of x equals integral 0 to pi by 2 y dash square plus z dash square plus 2yz into dz. Satisfying the boundary conditions, y of 0 equals 0, y of pi by 2 equals 1, z of 0 equals 0 and z of pi by 2 equals negative 1. Here we have dependent variables y and z and single independent variable x. We have capital F as the function y dash square plus z dash square plus 2yz. This represents function on two dependent variables y and z and independent variable is x. Also we have partial derivatives of dependent variable y dash and z dash represented in this function capital F. We will use system of Euler's equation. We have the first equation for dependent variable y written as fy minus dy dx of fy dash equals 0. Corresponding to the dependent variable z, we have the Euler's equation written as fz minus d by dx of fz dash equals 0. Dou f by dou y is fy, which is equal to 2z. We have d by dx of fy dash is d by dx of 2y dash, because dou f by dou y dash is obtained as 2y dash. We have d by dx of 2y dash equals 2y double dash. Similarly, when you evaluate partial derivative of f with respect to z, you get fz equals 2y. Here, you are considering y and y dash as constants. D by dx of fz dash is obtained as d by dx of 2z dash, which is 2z double dash. We have fz dash is partial derivative of f with respect to z dash, considering y dash, y and z as constants. Thus, we have fz dash is 2z dash. Now we will apply these values in the system of Euler's equation. We have this first equation giving 2z minus 2y double dash equals 0. This second equation will give us 2y minus 2z double dash equals 0. From these two equations, we have z equals y double dash and y equals z double dash. Give the names equation 1 and 2. When you differentiate equation 1, which is z equals y double dash with respect to x twice, when you differentiate it for the first time, you will get z dash equals y triple dash. When this equation is again differentiated with respect to x, you get z double dash equals y raised to 4, which is fourth order derivative of dependent variable y with respect to x. From equation 2, we have z double dash equals y. Therefore, this equation can now be rewritten as y raised to 4 equals y, which can also be written as d raised to 4 y upon dx raised to 4 minus y equals 0, which has the differential equation in terms of capital D written as d raised to 4 minus 1 operator on y equals 0. From this differential equation, we have the auxiliary equation obtained as m raised to 4 minus 1 equals 0. Solving m raised to 4 minus 1 equals 0, we will get m equals plus minus 1 or plus minus I. This is because I raised to 4 equals 1, minus I the whole raised to 4 equals 1. Similarly, positive 1 the whole raised to 4 and negative 1 the whole raised to 4 will also give values 1. Therefore, 4 roots of the equation m raised to 4 minus 1 equals 0 are identified as plus minus 1 and plus minus iota. We have the general solution obtained as y equals c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to negative x plus c3 cos x plus c4 sin x, where c1, c2, c3 and c4 are arbitrary constants. These representations are coming from roots plus minus 1. Corresponding to roots plus minus I, we get the terms c3 cos x plus c4 sin x. From this expression of y, we will now take derivative on both sides so that we get expression for y dash as c1 e raised to x minus c2 e raised to negative x minus c3 sin x plus c4 cos x. Again, differentiating this expression of y dash on both sides, we will get y double dash equals c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to negative x minus c3 cos x minus c4 sin x. From this expression of y double dash, using equation 1, we have z equals y double dash equals this same expression. Now we have obtained expressions for y and z. We will apply the boundary conditions in equations 3 and 4 to find out the particular values of c1, c2, c3 and c4. Applying boundary condition y of 0 equals 0 in equation 3, we get c1 plus c2 plus c3 equals 0. Applying boundary condition y of pi by 2 equals 1 in equation 3, we get the equation c1 e raised to pi by 2 plus c2 e raised to negative pi by 2 plus c4 equals 1. Similarly, applying boundary condition z of 0 equals 0 in equation 4, we get 0 equals c1 plus c2 minus c3. Applying boundary condition z of pi by 2 equals negative 1 in equation 4, we get negative 1 equals c1 e raised to pi by 2 plus c2 e raised to negative pi by 2 minus c4. We have 4 unknowns c1, c2, c3 and c4 to be found, and 4 equations are obtained. Solving the 4 equations, we get c1, c2, c3 are all 0 and c4 takes the value 1. When you substitute these values of c1, c2, c3 and c4 in equations 3 and 4, we get the required extremals as y equals sin x and z equals negative sin x. When we have 2 dependent variables, we will have 2 Euler's equation to be solved, and in that case we will get 2 extremals.